In this episode, parts have come back from the ultrasonic cleaner. We're going to have a look at them, see what condition they're in. Then we're going to peg out the plates, front and back, with some pegwood. Then we're going to check to see the pivot bushing alignments. They seem to be in pretty good nick, don't they? Nice and shiny now. Strike side. Yep, same for the time card, they look alright. Motion works. Goes on the minute arbor. The nuts that hold the plates together and the plates themselves have come up rather nicely. Certainly made a difference taking the oil out of those big pivots. That's the front plate and that's the back plate. You'll remember we put a piece of wire on that to designate the strike side main wheel, so we'll put that over there with the strike side components and the wheels. These are the going side train wheels and the escape wheel. We'll put the nuts into a dish here so they're readily accessible. Motion works we'll leave to later. Right, so that's got those set up now. Move the wheels for a moment. We'll put the back plate on a stand. And then we can start aligning the wheels. Before we start checking the pivots and the bushes, we'll peg out the bushes and the holes and the plate to make sure they're clean. If they're dirty, you're going to get an improper reading when you're checking them out to see what needs rebushing. So we'll just run up the plate, check each one. Yep, they're pretty clean. There's no marks on the pegwood there. Now run over the front plate. Same thing again. Some bushed holes, also some raw holes that were punched in the factory. Some have been rebushed or bushed, some haven't. Just to make sure that they're all clean before we start checking them. Yep, that looks pretty good. Okay, we'll start off with putting in the grate wheel to get our orientation, because if you don't, it's quite easy to set all the wheels upside down and they all look like they're apparently correct until you try to work the movement. All right, first wheel in. Put the top plate on. Lift them up carefully. Align the pivot into the bush, which is there. Get the posts set up. There's a slight bend in this top plate. We'll look at that in a moment. That's a seriously deformed hole there. That's not sliding in at all. Right, I'll round that off in a second. But in the meantime, it's sufficient if I hold this tightly. We can see what condition the pivots and bushes are in. All right, we're looking at that one there. Good heavens, look at the wobble on that. That's shocking. And the back. Looking at that pivot there. Marginally not quite so bad as the front. But the front plate is pretty horrible. Right. So, it looks like we're going to have some bushing to do on this movement, but I don't know that we're actually going to do it because I've spent more time looking at the movement and I can't see how the guy got the music box to work. After rummaging in my spare parts box, I eventually found a key that I could use to wind the music box spring up with. However, when I tried to wind the spring up, I found there was a match pushed into the winding slot. I tried to remove it with a fine pair of tweezers, but to no avail, so I was not able to get the spring wound up. This is just another weird mystery attached to this clock. It seems to have a pretty fair bow in that. Get a straight edge and check that out. Take top plate off. You can see how much that's out. That's out 2 mil. And we'll check this side here on the... That side's all right. Check it on the top. Yeah, it's out. Down that end. Straight edge across here. Yep. That is certainly out of whack a bit. See if that'll fit on without any wheels in it. Not only did he butcher numerous parts of the clock, he's obviously butchered the plates too. He's bent the plates way out of alignment. The bottom two posts are in. You can see how much that is out of alignment. And the same there. I'll bend those two posts a tiny little bit, not very much, tiny little bit, and see if it'll fit in better. If not, I'll get my parallel jaw pliers and get into it again. Now, that looks better. Yeah, all right. You can see all the posts are fitting in now, including that guy there. All right, problem solved. Now, back to checking the rest of the wheels. The first wheel goes there, second wheel will go there. That's its orientation. The teeth on that wheel will drive the trundles on that lantern pinion. All right, second wheel, let's check it out. Top plate on again. Align our posts. All right. Takes a little bit of getting it sorted, but It'll hold the bottom. Now, on that pivot, you can click in. Spins very freely, but so it should. Hold it there, that'll give us a... Right, now we're looking at that pivot there. Horrible. That pivot there. That's one of the mashed ones that he's hit with a hollow punch, and still crap. After he'd done that much damage to us, it's still rubbish, couldn't work. Oh, plenty of talent there by the sound of it. The last guy that played around with this. All right, third wheel. That's its orientation. Goes there. Top plate on. Line the posts. And it's got them. Hold the plates together. That pivot has missed entirely. So we'll have to do it again, obviously. It just fell out. Top plate on again. Align the pillars. And that one. And get our pivot into the bush. It's a bit. There we go. Try that. And then move it up. Tiny little bit. There we go. That's got him. Done. Right, let's check the pivots. Come in there. Yeah, pretty shonky. That one there. If you find this video helpful, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. Right, that's 3 out of 3 so far. If you would like to watch another of my clock repair videos, click on one of the thumbnails on the right-hand side of the screen.